Hello friends, I am Dr. Aniket Pavnoji and you are watching Basic Chemistry. In this video, we will learn application of molecular orbital theory to carbon monoxide molecule. First of all, if you have not subscribed my channel, click on subscribe and also hit the bell icon to get the notification of my new videos. Let's start the video. To understand application of molecular orbital theory to carbon monoxide molecule, it is very important to understand general principles applicable to heteronuclear diatomic molecule, which I have uploaded in the last video. If you have not watched my earlier video on application of molecular orbital theory to heteronuclear diatomic molecule, click on the above link and do watch it. Now, when we apply molecular orbital theory to dinitrogen molecule, we will get this diagram. Here, atomic orbitals of both the nitrogens are at the same level. According to the general principles, if we apply in the same way to the carbon monoxide molecule, considering the atomic orbitals of oxygen at lower energy compared to the atomic orbitals of carbon, we will get this diagram. In case of dinitrogen, there are total 14 electrons. In case of carbon monoxide also, there are total 14 electrons. So, dinitrogen and carbon monoxide both are isoelectronic. Therefore, just looking at the general principles, the carbon monoxide molecular orbital diagram will be similar to the molecular orbital diagram of dinitrogen. Just the difference will be atomic orbitals of oxygen being more electronegative will be at lower energy compared to the atomic orbitals of carbon. In case of dinitrogen, the bond order is calculated as 3. If the dinitrogen gas is ionized, one electron will be removed from the highest occupied molecular orbital. The bond order will become 2.5. As the bond order becomes fractional, it becomes unstable molecule and it will quickly accept one electron to become dinitrogen again. But when the same case is considered in case of carbon monoxide, which has the same bond order, if it is ionized to become CO+, the one electron will be removed from the sigma 2pz orbital. It also has to become unstable, but experimentally it is found that this CO plus molecule becomes a stable molecule. That means the molecular orbital diagram that we have considered similar to the dinitrogen cannot be considered for the carbon monoxide molecule. It needs to be different. So let's apply the molecular orbital theory to carbon monoxide molecule. In carbon monoxide, there is a carbon atomic number 6. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Oxygen atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. On the left hand side, we will have carbon atomic orbitals. On the right hand side, we will have oxygen atomic orbitals. And at the center, carbon monoxide molecular orbitals. In case of carbon, the valence orbitals are 2s and 2p. That is how there will be a 2s orbital and 2p orbitals, which is 2px, 2py and 2pz. Oxygen also has 2s and 2p orbitals. Just the difference is, as oxygen is more electronegative, the energy of these orbitals will be at lower side compared to the energy of the atomic orbitals of carbon. In one of my earlier videos, we have learned the mixing of orbitals in case of boron, carbon and nitrogen. If you have not watched that video, click on the above link and understand the concept of mixing of orbitals. Here in case of carbon, the energy gap between the 2s and 2pz orbital is very less, that is 510 kilojoules per mole. Now, due to similar symmetry and less energy gap between 2s and 2pz orbital, they mix up and they form two new orbitals. As two are combining, two will be formed. These are bonding orbital of spz carbon and antibonding orbital spz star carbon. Now, in case of oxygen, the energy gap between the 2s and 2p orbital is large, that is 1430 kilojoules per mole. But to overlap with the carbon atomic orbitals, the 2s and 2pz orbital of oxygen, it also get mixed up to form two new orbitals, which are spz oxygen bonding atomic orbital and spz star antibonding atomic orbital of oxygen. Now there are total 4 valence electrons in carbon, so 2 electron goes to spz carbon, 2 electron goes to spz star carbon. In case of oxygen, there are total 6 valence electrons. So 2 in spz oxygen, 2 in spz star oxygen, and 2 unpaired electrons in 2px and 2py according to the Hund's rule. Now, in salient features of molecular orbital theory, we have studied that the two atomic orbitals will overlap with each other only when they have comparable energy difference. Here, due to high electronegativity of oxygen, the spz orbital of oxygen is very low in energy. Therefore, it cannot overlap with spz orbital of carbon. It remains non-bonding. Now, bonding atomic orbital of carbon and antibonding atomic orbital of oxygen, they have similar symmetry and also comparable energy. Therefore, they overlap with each other to form one bonding orbital, that is sigma spz, and other antibonding orbital, that is sigma star spz. Now, there is no suitable orbital to overlap with antibonding orbital of carbon, therefore it remains non-bonding. The remaining 2px and 2py orbitals of carbon and oxygen, they participate in pi bonding and they form pi 2px pi 2py bonding molecular orbitals and pi star 2px pi star 2py antibonding molecular orbitals. 4 electrons from carbon and 6 electrons from oxygen. Total 10 electrons we have to fill in various molecular orbitals. 2 electrons goes to spz oxygen, 2 electrons goes to sigma spz, 4 electrons will go to pi 2px and pi 2py, and the last 2 electrons get occupied in spz star non-bonding molecular orbital of carbon. Here we should understand that the highest occupied molecular orbital is a non-bonding molecular orbital. Hence, in case of carbon monoxide, if it has to get ionized, the electron will be removed from the highest molecular orbital, which is a non-bonding molecular orbital. As this non-bonding molecular orbital has little antibonding character also, therefore the stability of the molecule gets increased. As the molecule becomes more stable, it doesn't accept an electron to become carbon monoxide again. It remains ionized due to high stability. This is how we cannot consider the molecular orbital diagram of carbon monoxide similar to the molecular orbital diagram of dinitrogen. Now let's see the molecular electronic configuration of carbon monoxide molecule. It is spz square as the two electrons are there in the non-bonding molecular orbital, then sigma spz square, then pi 2px square, pi 2py square, and the last spz square carbon, which is also a non-bonding molecular orbital. As there are no unpaired electrons, it is diamagnetic in nature. Now we can see that there are three bonding molecular orbitals containing pair of electrons, namely sigma spz, pi 2px and pi 2py. Therefore, bond order is calculated as 3. That is how we have understood that why N2 plus molecule is unstable, whereas CO plus molecule is a stable molecule. If you like my video, click on like, do share and subscribe my channel. If you want to mention something or ask something, mention it in the comment box. Also hit the bell icon to get the notification of my new videos and keep watching Basic Chemistry. Thank you.